Hi guys, welcome to the EDA analysis tutorials. So in this entire video, I'm going to talk about one of the data set which is from the Kaggle. We'll get more idea about how to start from the taking the raw data to the till to the complete analysis. These videos will be like into the different sections. So in this video section, we are going to talk about how to clean the data basically. And one more important thing, whatever you are seeing on my slide, this information I will talk at the end of the video, but you will get more clarity what we are going to do it. Okay, these are the some steps we need to follow when you are going to work on to the exploratory data analysis on the Kaggle data set. In this session, we are going to discuss about exploratory data analysis on the this data set. This is actually I taken from the Kaggle, so you can also download from the Kaggle. Already I provided this link into the video description, so you can take it up. That this data set contains the like 20 columns and almost more than 3 lakhs rows, and also this data set which is in the size of 65 MB. And anyway, let's explore this one. Yeah, let's start the analysis here. So I'm actually using the Google Colab, and this data set is actually taken from the Kaggle and contains the details of used cars in the Germany, which are on the sale on eBay. So this data set is not clean, and hence a lot of data needs to be cleaned. And so what we can do, right, we are going to use the data cleaning process in this, and we'll get more idea. And first let's start with that. So already I inputted the pandas here. So if I want to run this code, and you see that 1.15, this is the current version which I'm using in the Google Colab. And another one, you can see that if you want to upload the file, you just use this command. Since I already uploaded the file, I will show you. So this is a present working directory. I am using the content, and if I go and execute this ls command, you see that autos.csv, this is my file which is already done, right? I'm going to read this autos.csv file. So if you are not using this encoding thing, for example, I'm going to remove this one. If I go and execute this code, you'll get an exception saying that Unicode decode error. So we need to pass the right encoding here, UTF-8, which is not going to be decode the text. So what we can do, right, we have to provide the encoding is equal to Latin-1. Then if I go and execute this code, as this cell is going to accept it, and you see that there is a 371,528 records and 20 columns are there. So after that, we need to find the is there any null data or not. This is the something which we need to do it. And you see that there is a null data here. The vehicle type is which is like 37,869 rows are null, and similarly gearbox, model, and fuel type, all these columns having the null data, right? So for example, if you want to describe the data, just we can use the data dot describe function here, which will tell you all the descriptive statistics about the data which we have it. And you see that, but this function works only for the numerical columns, as we know that the price, year of registration, and these are all columns are in the numerical columns. And of course, we see the count and maximum value, minimum value, what is the 25%, 50% of the data, standard deviation, which is given everything here, right? Okay, but we'll talk about this. And one more important thing, you see that number of fixtures, the whole data which is in the zero, but this is not really required for entire data set. All 371,428 records contains zero only. So these kind of records we are going, these kind of columns we are going to delete basically, right? So let me go and check the each column wise. We can see that vehicle type is null and values dot sum. So there is a 37,869 records are the null. So what we are going to do, right, whichever the data is null, that data we are going to replace with the any dummy text. Okay, you can see that our data of vehicle type is fill any other and in place is equal to true. And finally, once you replace that other with the this null data, then finally zero records are there, no null data here. So now what I'm going to do, right, so data of offer type, so if you give the unique value here, so we can see that how many unique values are there. So this is basically like a categorical column, so I'm just going to enter. We see that like some German language words are there, so we are converting them into the English letters or English words. And to run this code, so to execute this code, basically like we are using the data of offer type is equal to data of offer type, and we are mapping the data. Basically these are the two German words, we are converting them into the English words. For that we are using the map function. So once we are done with this, we can run this, and this is got changed. If you want to check that same unique values, and then we can use this unique command type here. So this is the type command. Just you type and you see that now the unique values got changed, offer type and everything, right? So this is where like we can change the data as well. So what is our next immediate step is that we are going to plot the data, right? So this is a plot the data. What we can do, right? Dist plot, we are using it, and matplotlib pyplot, and after that we are taking the figure size and to increase the figure size. And I'm going to run this dist plot here, and it may take little time, and it will display the whole data. And if you remember here, I am using the KD is equal to true, and we can also change this one to the kind is equal to KD also. That works. So KD is one type of distribution, right? So kernel distribution estimate, so we can say that. Yeah, so let it execute, then I will do it the next. It's taking time, let it be. So you can see there is a okay, so it is done now. There is a graph which is printed, but this data we are not able to see it in bigger format. So what we can do, right, we can use the same SNS dot displot, and data is equal to data, and x is equal to year of registration, this is one column, and kind is equal to KDE, and height is equal to 10. So kind is like by default it is a histogram, but we are given here kernel density estimate. So now you can see there is a graph which is showing most of the registrations happen at 2000. Okay, let it be. Now I'm going to take the box plot. This is a SNS dot box plot, and for vehicle type, x is equal to here it is a vehicle type, and y is equal to price. So for each vehicle type, what would be the price? But this is not giving the right information, because based on the vehicle type, price is going to be vary. So if you can ask me the question, why you are taking the vehicle type here? The reason is that the price is mostly depending on the vehicle type. Okay, so we can say it is in a very important. This is a dependent variable, but is a, it is depending on this. This can decide that mostly. So that is the reason. But there is so much of outlier range here, so we need to delete that outliers. To do that activities, first we need to calculate the median for each vehicle type price. You can see here data dot group by and vehicle type, and you take the price here, the price dot median. Similar for the, like you calculate the 75% quantile and 25% quantile and all. The basic idea is that the range, in that range only we are going to take the data. It is above the range we can consider the like outlier data, so we are going to delete it. So my point is going to tell you here, the IQR is nothing but interquartile range. To calculate this one, basically we use the quantile 75 minus quantile 25. As for formula, we are going to use into 1.5 plus median. So finally we'll get the IQR here. So if I run this one, you see that for each vehicle type, what is the range? So for this is like, this is a vehicle type, we should not cross this value. For bus also we should not cross, for cabrio also we should not cross. So particular every vehicle type there is a value, that value we should not cross it. Cross in the sense, for example, if you take SUV is 28,800, but for example if any one of the vehicle is sold out at $50,000, and we don't consider for the data set, that is considered as a like outlier. Okay, so it will create a problem. Okay, so how we can remove the outliers in this case? For you can take each vehicle type here, the data of vehicle type and your, and the data of price, which is less than or equal to 8434. This is the one, the same value which I have given here. So similarly, like the price is also same. Okay, so price for bus and price for cabrio, there are all this data which I am checking it. Finally I am preparing the data. So once if you prepare the data, so when you run this code, it will remove it. See, overall records of data is 380,000, and we removed almost like I think 370,000. If I'm going a little bit to top, you see that 370,000, but almost we reduce it to the 90,000 records from the given data set. Okay, so that's where like we are preparing the so that is actually flat, I mean raw data. We are changing into the cleaner data now. So to remove the outliers, we use this code and remove that. That is where the shape is there. Now if I go and run this data.info, and you see that there is one interesting point. So most of the columns which has having the 280,043 rows, but there are few columns like fuel types. Another one is like gearbox and not repair damage. These columns having the less rows. That means some of the rows which is in the null data. So how we can handle the null data? This is called imbalanced data. So when you have the imbalanced data, so what is our next step is that we are going to check the null value and remove that null value, or like replace them with the some text here. So basically I am replacing the text null value with the other, and finally, like after running this code, what will happen, right? So that is a zero will show. So null values is zero. It is the same case for the model column. It is the same case for the fuel type column. And it is also same case for the not repaired damage also. So finally, we removed all, I mean, we made the balanced data. Previously, it is the imbalanced data. We filled with some data set. And if we go and check the info function, you see that all the columns is having the same number of rows, right? This is how we can conclude that this data is the balanced now. So we are making the cleaned and balanced data. And also you see that data of number of pictures, when I go and run this code, and you see that all the data which is a zero only, if I go and execute this code, this is zero. But I don't want zero data to be given as a cleaned data, so I want to delete it because it is not going to impact anything. So after that, when you go and check the info function, so here now your columns list is a 0 to 18 only, right? So not 19. So one column is deleted. So finally, and also one more check we need to do, if there is any differences between the date format here. So date crawled and date created both are same only. So we don't need to worry about if the format of the dates is same, and we don't need to worry about if in case if the format is not same, then we have to go and do the changes. Okay. So coming to the point, once we're done with all this data, we are going to use the pandas data frame dot to CSV function. We are going to send this data to the one CSV file. So I'm going to use the cleaned auto one dot CSV. The final data will be moved into the, you can see here left side, there is one section called here. So there is auto one dot CSV file which is created. If you want to check that file is created or not, we can use the ls command, and we can also see that file name here. I'm going to read that file, the cleaned auto 1.csv, as I said, that is there in this section. So we are going to read that file now. So what I'm going to do, right? So we'll read now new data.shape. So let me execute this code and whether we are getting that same length of it. Yes, we got the same data. See, this is the new columns, and new columns we can say means one column which we deleted, and also rows are like updated now. Previously it is 370,000 records, now it is shrinked to the 280,000 records. Finally, if you want to plot that one, see the box plot, and you will see that great visualization now, because we actually removed the outliers. When you remove the outliers, we can see the data set like this. This is how the data which is we are seeing it now. And similar fashion, for example, if I want to check the displot, which is one more important thing, guys. Distribution plot, DIST plot, which is the old, that is a deprecated, we have to use the displot here. So when I'm going to use the displot here, and also we can check the data, which is not changed much. We are not done anything at this point. But if you look at the price level, vehicle type at price level, we changed a lot. That's what you are seeing on my screen. So, and also like if you want to plot the data, like see the for each vehicle, how much data, like for example, you see this each vehicle type, how many number of vehicles actually sold out, right? That is also we can see. So to show these values on the screen, like on top of the each bar graph, we can use this for p in axis.patches and annotate. So what is we are going to annotate? We take the get height and we are going to annotate and show that information. Okay, so definitely guys, this is how we do the analysis. Thus right now we have the very cleaned data set. We'll continue our further analysis in the upcoming videos. Thank you so much. There are some very important points we should note down for the EDA analysis, and you see here We need to first describe the data and see is there any numerical columns, how the data which is distributed, and find the null values on the data set. If you find any null values, we can replace them with the default values if it is a text, and also replace the null values with the mean values if it is an integer. Generally we take like this and plot the distribution of the whole data by using the histograms, and we see that how the data which is plotted. And also we can use the box plot to find the quartile range. Basically it is can help you to figure out the outliers. So by once you find the outliers, we can remove from the plot, find the outliers from the plot. That's where like we use the box plot, we can remove those outliers. Once you remove those outliers, and that's where like most of the data will be cleaned. And also we need to remove the entire column which is null. For example, if you find any one of the feature column which is in the null data, we can remove it. And also find the correlation coefficients from the whole data sets and remove if it is any data which is highly correlated. And also check that if data which is in the not in the same language or different text is there, we can change it to that one into the different text. But it is not case for the all the data sets, we need to be considered for that one too. And more important thing that we need to maintain the same date format when you are using into the data sets. That's where like it is very useful when you are going to train the model in the machine learning perspective. These are the few points which I have given, but in upcoming sessions I will talk more about this EDA analysis, and you'll get more idea. Oh,